Hello, my fellow card lovers, and welcome. For a very long time, you guys have been requesting a remake with audio of this tutorial on how to create a dynamic hexagonal screw block in AutoCAD. I am sorry for the time it took, but here we are finally. Unfortunately, I do not have a more recent version of AutoCAD installed on my computer, so I am just going to reuse the old footage, onto which I will stitch the narration and some special effects. As always, I am going to walk you through every single steps, and hopefully at the end you will be able to do it on your own, no matter what version of AutoCAD you are using. We are going to start by creating the base geometry, onto which we are going to add geometry constraints, then dimensional constraints, and finally add a table so that from a single block you can create all the screws you will ever need for your project. You will also be able to amaze your friends and coworkers by making it snap automatically to lines and stretch it to set the length as you go. So without further ado, let's get to it. We are going to start with a new drawing. As you can see, I took some time beforehand to create these two layers. In the construction layer, we will have the screw geometry, and in the center line, we will have the center lines. Now, because we will need to access quite often the layer drop-down box, we are going to add it to the quick access toolbar. To do so, right-click on it and select Add to Quick Access Toolbar. Next, because we are going to use a very limited set of tools, and down the road we will need the maximum drawing space possible, we are going to reach to this icon on the right edge of the ribbon tabs, and we are going to select Minimize to Tabs. To finish, we are going to make sure that we have the right snapping and tracking settings active, as you can see here. Now we start with the screw head in front view, and we will create first a cycle by typing C followed by 0 and 0 in the dynamic input box, and next we are going to press D for the diameter input, and we will enter 15 millimeters. Next, we will type POL for polygon, then 6 to create an hexagon. For the center, we are going to type CEN to specify the center, and then we will move and select the center of the cycle. The next prompt is to define if our hexagon will be inscribed in a cycle or circumscribed about a cycle. We will use the circumscribed about a cycle option. To finish, we are going to make sure the hexagon is oriented as such, and we will click at the intersection of the cycle and the polar tracking at 0 degrees. Now we will create the two center lines. So we type L to start the line command, then we move up to this corner of the hexagons so that the endpoint snap and the polar tracking at 90 degrees are activated. Then we type 3 to create the first point of the line at 3 millimeters from that corner. And for the second point, we select this one. Now we select the line and stretch it 3 millimeters downward like so. Next, we move to the layers drop down and we select the center line layer to move our first center line to that layer. To create the horizontal center line, we type Ro for the rotate command. Then for the base point, we type CEN to use the center of the cycle, and then we select the cycle. Before entering the rotation angle, we use the down arrow key on the keyboard to activate the copy option and press enter to accept the default 90 degree angle, and we are done with the screw front view. We start the side view with the center line. So we type L, and for the first point, we move close to this endpoint to activate the endpoint snap. And with the polar tracking at 0 degree, we move something like 15 millimeters and click to create the first point. With the polar tracking still locked at 0 degree, we will input 40 millimeters for the length of the center line. Now we select the line and move it to the center line layer. Next, P to launch the pan command, and we will pan from right to left. L for the line command again, and we are going to start the screw head by moving back to this corner on the front view. And once the polar tracking is locked at 0 degree, we will move and click somewhere like this for the first point. We will do the same for the second point. Oops, the property palette is on the way, so let me move it out of the way. There we go. Okay, now we can hover on the top of this corner and click on the intersection of the polar tracking at 0 degrees and the polar tracking at 270 degrees to create the second point. Now we move to the right and type 6 millimeters for the head height. Then again, we click at the intersection of the horizontal and the vertical polar tracking for the third point, and back to this endpoint to complete the rectangle. Escape to finish the line command. Now to draw the body, type O for the offset command. Next, we type L to define the layer. Then using the down arrow on the keyboard, we will select the current one, which is the layer construction, as you can see. Otherwise, the offsetted geometry will be created in the original layer. 5 millimeters is okay for the offset distance, so we press enter to keep it. Then we select the center line and click on this side to place the first offset. Then we select the center line again and click on this side for the second offset. Escape to finish. Now L for the line tool, and EA to activate the nearest object snap option. Then we select the top line somewhere like this, and with the polar tracking locked at 90 degrees, we click on the bottom line like this, then escape to finish. As you can see, the lines are longer than necessary, so we are going to trim them. We type X for extent, and we box select these three lines. Next, we press enter so that we can use any of these lines as boundary objects. And with the shift key press down to activate the trim option, we cut this end and this one. Escape to finish. Again, O for the offset tool. We enter 1 millimeter for the distance, and we select this line and click inside. Then this second one and click inside. Escape to finish. Now the line tool. First point, the endpoint of this line. For the second point, we make sure the polar tracking is locked at 45 degrees and we click at the intersection with this line. Then a vertical line up to this line, and we finish at this endpoint. Escape to finish. Now we press enter or the space bar to activate the line tool again, and EA for the nearest object snap. Then we click somewhere like this for the first point. And with the polar tracking at 90 degrees, move up to this line and click to create the line. This line will define the thread length. We launch the extend tool again, and now we select these three vertical lines. We press enter to use them as boundary objects. Then with the shift key press down, we will remove this side and this one, these two ends, and these ones. Escape to finish. Now to finish the screw body, we select these two lines and we move to the Home tab and expand it. Then we move to the Properties panel and change the color to red. Although we change the color to red, this line will remain in the construction layer. Okay, now let's add more details to the head. We use the line tool again, and with the polar tracking lock at 0 degree, we move back and select this line for the first point, then this one for the second point, and enter to reset the line tool. We do the same for this second corner and first point, then second point. Now line tool again, first point this corner, this time the polar tracking should be locked at 30 degrees and we make sure that the second point is at the intersection with the center line and not with the vertical line, then escape to finish. Next line from this corner, then at 30 degrees up to this previous line, escape to finish. Now C for cycle, the center point should be this end point, and for the radius we will use the intersection with this line like so. Next we select the cycle, then MI for the mirror tool. The mirror line should be the center line like so. We type N to preserve the original cycle. C again for cycle, the center point should be this intersection point. For the radius, we will select the intersection of this small cycle and this horizontal line. Now we select these cycles, this line, this one, this cycle, and this line. Then X for the extend tool, enter to use our selection as boundary edges. Then with the shift key press down, we trim this two, this one, and escape to finish. Next we select these two last lines and delete them manually using the delete key on the keyboard. Alright, we are almost there. Few details left to do. So extend tool again, then enter to set all the objects in the drawing as boundary edges. Then with the shift key pressed down again, we select this and this, then escape to finish. Line tool again, we press shift and then right click to activate the temporary object snap overrides, and in the list we are going to select tangent. Now we will make sure that the first point of our line is tangent to the arc, somewhere like this. And for the second point, we will enter first the at character, then 30 millimeters for the relative distance, and then 120 degrees for the angle, then escape to finish. To check if the angle is correct, we enter DAN for dim angular. And on the preview, we can see that the value is 30 degrees, which is okay. We have it right. Escape to cancel. X for the extend tool. We select the arc and these two lines. Then this one. Then enter to use them as boundary edges. And with the shift key pressed down again, we will trim this part of the last line. This one for the vertical line and this part of the horizontal line. Escape to finish. Now we select the resulting line and type MI for the mirror tool, and again we will use the center line as the mirror line. Now we have a close look on this corner, and with the extend tool we will trim this portion and this one. Escape to finish, then Z for zoom, then E for extends, and with that we are done for the base geometry. In the next part we are going to add geometric constraints. I hope I will see you there, and thanks for watching.